scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence. You may now be seated.
Today's lunch is beef nachos, refried beans, shredded lettuce, tomatoes, fresh fruit, and milk. I'm here as Mrs. Fernandez announcing the Super Stingrays.
Good morning, boys and girls, and I'm here to announce the much anticipated Super Stingrays. Now hang on, hang tight, because you really have to hear these descriptions. Now remember, this is an outstanding privilege. These are the cream of the crop for each grade level for the habit. And we're talking about the habit number one, be proactive. Here are our winners. For pre-K, we have Matias Almonte. Check this out. Matias is always on time. He loves to participate and learn, completes his homework, demonstrates true skills of a little leader. Congratulations, Matias. And from Ms. Hernandez's class, for the female, we have Valentina Maurucci. Woo! All right, Valentina, always participating, raising her hand, demonstrating the true model of being a proactive scholar, loving to learn, sitting correctly, paying attention to the teacher. Congratulations, Valentina and Matias. Now for kinder, we have Damien Aragon from Ms. Medina's class. Damien is always ready and prepared, ready to participate, remembers the class rules without having to be reminded. That's what it's all about, setting yourself up and being ready. And we have Madison Giraldo from Mrs. Bernandez's class. Madison is always ready to go, accepts the fact that she cannot always be picked because there are other students in the classroom, and ready to help others. She always has a second plan to keep herself busy when she finishes early. Talk about being proactive, Madison. From first grade, we have Adrián Piloto from Ms. J. Ramos. AJ takes responsibility of completing his work and making sure everything is done completely. He learned how to get to Google Classroom on his own, be proactive, and complete Google Forms without barely any assistance after practicing on his own. And we have, from Mrs. Martinez's class, Sanai Brown. Sanai is always working. When she's done with an assignment she does not tell me she's done, but proactively begins reading a book. She is a proactive leader. Good job, first grade. Second grade, we have Santiago Alamo from Ms. Novaro's class. Santi has been proactive by making Google Classroom his responsibility since his mom was having a hard time understanding it. I personally saw this. Great job, Santiago, on being proactive. And we have Isabella Menendez from Mrs. Cano's class. Listen to this. This student struggled with remote learning the first few weeks, but has made such an improvement. She participates, has responses ready to go, has even helped her peers stay organized. She struggled with it at first, but took it upon herself to learn it, so now she can teach others. Great job! See, it's not always easy at first. We have to work on it. That's what being proactive helps us do. Third grade, Steven Gonzalez from Ms. B. Lopez. Steven deserves to be the third grade super stingray because he has shown how to be proactive. One way, he reaches out to the teacher when there's technical issues. He takes on an active role in his learning by making sure he overcomes these difficulties. And he's even gone so far to ask his teacher and parents to help him so that he can stay focused. He knows success is determined by his actions. Job, Steven. And then we have Sophie Zabala from Ms. R. Lopez's class. Sophie is respectful, hardworking, takes initiative to help her peers, even on Zoom. She volunteers to help solve problems, is always ready for class and eager to learn. She uses her time wisely and is proactive by getting her work done without anyone reminding her and having a backup plan. Good job, third grade. Fourth grade. I got Richard Rivas from Mrs. Barreto. Richard, it was so nice to meet you. Welcome. He's always participating in every subject and trying his best to get good grades. He's responsible and makes sure that all of his work is completed on time and done correctly. I'm sorry, Stingray, I keep poking you. He is ready to go and is not afraid to ask questions to make sure he understands. That's being proactive, boys and girls. And we have Elizabeth Debs from Ms. V. Garcia. She's displayed habit one since the beginning. I have seen this too. Always finding something productive to do when she's done with her work early. Never has to be called on attention for being off task. Last week, when the Nearpod quiz would not load, she made sure to send a reminder email after class to the teacher that she needed to make up the quiz. She knew she hadn't done it. She's always prepared for class, and even though she's on virtual school, in her own house, she's ready to go. And finally, fifth grade, Adrian Sierra from Ms. Gomez's class. Adrian is well prepared and displays a no-nonsense attitude. He may have baseball tournaments to attend after school, but he makes sure that he's ready to go and his assignments are done ahead of time so he doesn't miss out on anything. He's proactive by making sure he has everything completed before he heads out. That's a great balance and a great idea. And finally, we have our last super stingray, Melissa Ramos from Ms. Folguera's class. Meli is just always working hard to be proactive. when she struggled to submit an assignment digitally, she reached out to the teacher every day until a solution was found. She was proactive, found an alternate way to submit it and get credit, and is always aiming for higher things, like AR Superstar. She sets her own high goals and has always met or exceeded them. Each time, she just keeps going higher and higher. So impressed with her work ethic. Boys and girls, congratulations. So proud of you. Thank you for being proactive. Thank you for having everything ready to go and being a great example for your peers. Can't wait to see who has habit number 2 under wraps for next month. Have a great day. Congratulations to our super stingrays. Have a great day.
Thank you, Mrs. Fernandez, and congratulations, Super Stingrays. Remember, Stingers, to check out my website for the new challenge of the month, and don't forget to send me any photos or videos so you can be featured here in the morning announcements. The link is shown below. And also make sure to give a Stingray shout out to any of your friends or classmates displaying a habit. You can submit a shout out in the link shown below. And on Friday, Mr. Castillo will be here to announce the Stingray shout outs. Teachers and students only can submit a shout out.
And don't forget Stingrays, October is happening number 2. Begin with the end in mind.
Thank you for tuning in to Stingray TV. Hope you have a great day. And don't forget to swim.